52% of our world cannot access healthcare. We make healthcare go further so every community can thrive. Hi, I'm Edward Booty, founder and CEO of Reach 52, a Singapore-headquartered social enterprise. I started my career in a big pharmaceutical company, focusing on medicines access, then went to the UK, focusing on digitizing the health service. So what inspired me to start Reach 52 is firstly that 52% of our planet, or 3.7 billion people, cannot access healthcare. Full stop. One of the biggest barriers in delivering health services is simply the lack of internet and the lack of payment infrastructure. So for all the talk of telehealth and digital health, you need the internet. And if you need to pay out of pocket, you need payment systems, not cash, which simply doesn't exist. So Reach 52 trains women in rural communities to act like a health worker. We hire them, we train them, we pay them. And then through our network of women and technology on the ground that allow one or two women per village to collect data on healthcare needs first. We then work with governments to run a range of healthcare programs and give access to doctors. But through the same network of women and technology, we also order discounted medicines, insurance plans, consumer health products that are delivered right back to that rural community, none of which can really access any health services at all at the moment. All of our technology is built to work completely offline. We log in, we sync, and our network of women on the ground do not need the internet for 1, 2, 3 months. One story that's really stuck with me was actually a woman in Cambodia. She had been buying fake medicine all of her life. She was about 75 years old or something. With Reach 52, we've educated her on what diabetes is, we've got her proper screening and diagnosis, and access to high quality, affordable treatments available in her village for a significantly discounted price. What that really allowed us to do was combat the epidemic of fake medicine that exists in our region, and secondly, improve her health outcomes because she did have diabetes, and without a proper intervention, it would have got worse. And I think that's one of the more recent projects that I'm most proud of personally. Within Southeast Asia and Africa and other developing regions, we have to face up to the fact there's just a lack of qualified healthcare professionals. We need to completely rethink how different partners in healthcare work together. Public sector and private sector need to ignore the past, ignore the history, and rebuild integrated models to help connect everyone to healthcare. So with all these challenges in mind, digitization clearly holds the keys towards health for all. So as a network of entrepreneurs or change makers, we have to really address these challenges head on, and the opportunity for scale and impact is just amazing.